Hey, what up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. We now have much more clarity when it comes to the Dak Prescott situation. More on that in a second. But first, thanks for liking, commenting, subscribing, and ringing the bell to this channel. That way you're always notified when I make a new video. It should come as no surprise to anybody that if the Cowboys can't come to a long-term agreement with Dak Prescott by the March 12th deadline, Cowboys will be hitting Dak Prescott with the franchise tag. But more specific on that, here's what Ian Rappaport had to say on this on Monday.
A specific tag for Dak Prescott is likely to be the exclusive tag, roughly $33 million. It's a situation that prevents any other team from negotiating with Dak Prescott or trying to make a run at him. That is why the specific tag matters, in addition to the fact that it's obviously more money than the non-exclusive tag. The Cowboys are going to still try somehow, some way to get a deal done with Dak, so maybe they have the franchise tag for Amari Cooper.
If the Cowboys do hit him with that tag on March 12th, they would have until July 15th then to come to a long-term deal. But here's the rub. And there's a couple of things. Jeremy Fowler and Dan Graziano of ESPN both reported that the Cowboys and Dak Prescott walked away from a deal worth $33 million. That was the number, which, if you're Dak Prescott, why would you accept a deal which is the exact same amount that they're going to franchise tag you at? At this point, Dak Prescott could get $33 million this year on a franchise tag and even more money if tagged again next year. So accepting any deal that averages $33 million per year is going to be less than what you'd be getting even if you're franchise tagged in two consecutive years. Now, it seems even more clear that the Cowboys want a long-term deal done, something in the neighborhood of 5 to 6 years for Dak Prescott, and it seems like Dak Prescott wants something more shorter term, more like Kirk Cousins, that's going to be 3 years all guaranteed, that way that he can hit free agency again in the prime of his career, as opposed to another deal which would be more friendly to the Cowboys, allow them to restructure the deal down the road if they need to, and give them the flexibility to have Dak Prescott signed up long term and not hit free agency again when he could cash in because the contracts for quarterbacks are going to be even higher. But from Dak's camp, he's probably thinking, I'll sign a long term deal, but that's where I want to get into the $38 to $40 million a year range. You might think that's preposterous, but for Dak Prescott, he's more willing to take a long term deal and be tied up if he can get more money in it. The lesser money, the $33, $34, $35 million range, is probably something that he wants on a more short-term deal. That way, he can cash in again in 3 years from now when assuming he's still playing at a high level and also assuming contract numbers for quarterbacks go up even more. So the standard would be even higher than it is today, which is why Dak Prescott says, if you want me long-term, you're going to have to give me a ton of money on an average per year basis, which is probably something the Cowboys are not comfortable with. Now, you might be watching this and your eyes are glazing over with numbers and $33 million. These numbers are absurd and hard to think about and deal with. But at the end of the day, Dak Prescott is doing what's in his own best self-interest. You could fault him for that if you're a Cowboys fan and say he should do what's in the best interest of the Cowboys, or you could look at this realistically and say Dak's always going to do what's in his own best self-interest because the Cowboys are only looking out for their best self-interest. But if the Cowboys do place a franchise tag on Dak Prescott, that exclusive tag, which means he cannot negotiate with anybody else, would be paid $33 million at a bare minimum next season. There's concerns that if that happens, that Dak might sit out the offseason training program, which with a new head coach and new verbiage and a new offense to learn is difficult and would be damning on the Dallas Cowboys and their potential success this season. But I think it's a leverage point that cuts both ways. If Dak Prescott plays next season on the franchise tag, he's effectively playing again in a contract year, which means he's going to need to put up big time numbers again in order to prove that he's worth the $35 to $40 million on an annual basis that he wants. But if he's not at mini camps and off-season of work learning the new offense, he's as much at a disadvantage from a personal level as the Cowboys are from a team level. He'd be cutting off his nose despite his face. And look, I know Dak is a lightning rod on this page or any other place in the comments. And a year ago today, we would argue he was top 15. And where he was in that top 15, you could make a pretty good argument. I would say now, a year later, you could argue he's top 10, which means that his ceiling is getting higher, which means he does have the ability to become a better version of what he's already been, which means you can sit there and say you think you know what Dak Prescott is, but he's shown the last 2 years that he hasn't hit his ceiling yet, so he could become a top five quarterback. And last time I checked, you pay a guy a contract, not for what they've done, but for what they will do. make no mistake about it, Dak Prescott this season was a product of the work he put in last offseason. And remember, Dak was phenomenal, an MVP candidate up until that Patriots game, when the rest of the season was very much a major question mark. With all that being said, I predict the Cowboys will place the exclusive franchise tag on Dak Prescott on March 12th. And I predict that in 2020, Dak Prescott will not be playing on the franchise tag, and that the Cowboys will be able to get a long-term deal done, whether it's a short-term deal with money fully guaranteed or a more long-term deal with more money on an average per year basis, probably gives us a pretty good indication of who will win in negotiations.